Hello students, previously in the beer series we have discussed ingredients of beer making, in which we discussed that there is a water, barley, hops and yeast which act as the main ingredients. Today we are going to discuss the beer manufacturing process. How the beer is made? The steps are as follows: barley, steeping, green malt, malting or kilning, grist, mash, wort, hop back, straining, wet fermentation, filtration, priming and fining, cooling and pasteurization, and then at last packaging. So it is said that during the Babylon 4000 years ago, that for a month after the wedding, the bride's father would supply his son-in-law with all the mead he could drink. Mead is a honey beer, and because the calendar was lunar based, this period was called honey month, which we know today as honeymoon. So the first step in beer making is steeping. The grains are soaked in huge tanks for about 50 to 60 hours at a temperature of around 10 degrees Celsius. Then we go for malting. The grains are then taken to the malt room, where they are spread and allowed to breathe while sprouting. The grains are continuously stirred to avoid the roots getting entwined, and also to ensure all grains get a chance to breathe. The process takes between 8 to 15 months at a temperature of 12 to 21 degrees Celsius. Then we go for germination. With around 40% of moisture and a temperature of 12 to 21 degrees Celsius, the grains start to germinate, and this causes the enzymes to act there by converting the starch into sugar. Kilning process. In this process, the grains are spread on stone floors with wires beneath. This causes germination to stop and also roast the malt simultaneously. Depending on the type of beer to be produced, the roasting is done. For example, mild ales are kilned at 65 degrees Celsius, pales are done at 85 degrees Celsius, and so on. Sieving is done to remove the primule, which is further sold as cattle feed. Mashing, it is one of the important process. It is a roller mill in which the grains are roughly broken, which is known as grist. Note, the grains are not converted to powder, they are coarsely broken. Extraction of sugar, known as decoction, involves the heating of the grist with water at 35 degrees Celsius in a lauter tun. The temperature of the water is gradually increased to 70 degrees Celsius. The resultant liquid is known as wort. Wort is a sugary liquid. Brewing. The wort is transferred to brewing vessel. Hops are added. Wort is boiled for around 1 to 2 hours, which extract the bitter flavor of hops. Hop back. The spent hops are retained on the screen base of the hop back. The hot water filter through them. The spent hops are sold for cattle uses. The hop flavored wort is channelized to wort receiver. Cooling and pitching. The wort is cooled down to 15 degrees Celsius. The cooled wort is transferred to the fermentation tank. Process of fermentation. For ale beer, the yeast which is used is Saccharomyces cerevisiae. The yeast is added to the wort. The yeast stick together and multiply and form a surface layer on the liquid. Convert sugar into alcohol and carbon dioxide. The liquid ferment for a week at a much higher temperature of 15 to 25 degrees Celsius. For the process of fermentation in lager beer, the yeast which is used is Saccharomyces carlsbergensis. and it is used for bottom fermentation. The yeast ferment at a cooler temperature range between 5 to 9 degrees Celsius. Maturation and pasteurization. For ale beer, they are racked into a storage tank stored for 3 to 21 days and may be pasteurized or unpasteurized. For lager beer, they are racked into a storage tank and matured for 10 to 24 weeks at a temperature range of 1 to 3 degrees Celsius. Brightening and clarifying. This is one of the crucial steps in beer making process. Once the beer making is completed, we need to clarify the beer. The beer are brightened with the addition of fining, carbonated and filtered water. So through charcoal sheets or fining process, they can be clarified. Next is packaging. So beer can be packed into different containers and they are as follows. They can be packed in bottles, cans, kegs, casks and tanks. So these are different methods of packaging beer. In the next session, we are going to discuss about types of beer. What are different types of beer? So we have learned that basically there are two types of beer. One is the bottom fermented beer and the second is top fermented beer. Or we can say that one is lager and the second one is ales. So we are going to learn what are these two different types of beer and how they are different from each other. And what are the various types available under the category of lagers and ales. Thank you.